How are you?
I am fine. I am K. Jansirani. I am working as a teacher in Dhanlakshmi Secondary School. I am taking Commerce and Accountancy for 11th and 12th standard. I am very happy to see you all again. Now I am going to take 12th standard Accountancy. I hope you know very well about what is the meaning of bookkeeping, what is accountancy, how to write journal, how to post into ledger, what are the types of subsidiary books, how to prefer trading, profit and loss and balance sheet, how to find the error. I think you know very well about. Now we enter into the new chapter. The name is Accounts from Incomplete Records. The name itself having incomplete records means it is not a perfect record. In Indian Companies Act 2013, Section 128, Subsection 1, they are mentioned in India, some organization should maintain double entry system except the small size organization and partnership firm. Now we see the meaning of incomplete record. Look at the board. Meaning of incomplete records. When accounting records are not strictly maintained according to double entry system, these records are called incomplete accounting records. I am repeat again. When accounting records are not strictly maintained according to double entry system, these records are called incomplete accounting records. It is an incomplete and unscientific way of bookkeeping. It is an unscientific way of bookkeeping. So it was called single entry system of bookkeeping. It is 2-mark question. Note down, students. The next one, features of incomplete record. What is the meaning of feature? Characteristics. What are the characteristics of incomplete records? The first point, nature. It is an unscientific and unsystematic way of recording transaction. So it is an unscientific, unsystematic way of recording transaction. The second point, types of accounts maintained. What are the types of accounts? We know very well, personal, real, nominal. But here, they only cash and personal accounts are maintained. Third point, lack of uniformity. There is no uniformity in recording the transactions among different organizations. So there is no uniformity. The last one, suitability. It is suitable for small size sole traders and partnership firm. So collectively we recall, what are the features? Nature, that means unscientific and unsystematic. Types of accounts maintained, only cash and personal accounts. Lack of uniformity, there is no uniformity. Suitability, only for small size sole traders and partnership firm. It is 1 3-mark question. Now, what are the limitations of incomplete records? Limitation, what is the meaning? Disadvantage. What are the disadvantages of incomplete records? Lack of proper maintenance of records, because they are not maintained all the transactions. The next one, it is difficulty to prepare trial balance. We know very well, if you want to prepare trial balance means, we know the debit balance as well as credit balance. But here, they are maintained only one type of accounts only. The third one, difficulty in ascertaining true profitability of the business. Obviously, we are not entering all the transaction means, we cannot find out the real profit or loss in the business organization. The fourth one is difficulty in ascertaining financial position. Why we need to prepare the profit balance sheet? Why we need to prepare balance sheet for the organization? We want to know the real financial position of the business. But here, it is not possible because we are not entering all the transaction. At the meantime, the error and fraud cannot be detected easily. We cannot find out the error also. It is unacceptable to government and other authorities because it is not, it not show the real profit, real financial position. So the government also not acceptable. So these are the limitations of the incomplete record. Okay, are you understand, students? Now we see the difference between double entry system and single entry system. There is a nature, then double entry system, incomplete record, recording of transaction. In double entry system, both debit and credit aspect of all the transactions are recorded. But in the case of incomplete record, all the transactions are not recorded completely. So in the recording of transaction, in double entry system, we enter all the transaction, but in incomplete record, we are not record all the transaction. Second point, types of accounts maintained. Already we saw in feature, in double entry system, personal, real and nominal accounts are maintained, but here personal and cash accounts only maintained. The third one, preparation of trial balance. In double entry system, it is possible to prepare the trial balance. Trial balance can be prepared, but here the trial balance cannot be prepared. The fourth one, suitability. It is suitable for all the types of organization, but here it is suitable for small size sole traders, partnership firm only. The last one, determination of true profit or loss. Here it is possible, but here it is not possible. So these are called difference between double entry system and incomplete record. It is a sometime there will be asked 3 mark question, sometime it will be asked in 5 mark question also. Okay, now we see how to calculate the profit and loss through the statement of affairs. Here, calculation of profit or loss through statement of affairs. How to find out the profit and loss? The difference between the closing capital and the opening capital is taken as profit or loss of the business. What is the meaning of closing capital? In year end, unsold stock is called closing capital. What is the opening capital? The business starting capital is called opening capital. How to calculate the profit and loss? See the format. The first one, closing capital. In the closing capital, you should add drawings. What is the meaning of drawings? The amount withdraw from the business for its personal use means it is called drawings. So you should add to the closing capital. Otherwise, the closing capital will be very low. Then, less additional capital. Additional means the capital introduced in between the business means it is called additional capital. Suppose you are introduce additional capital means you should less from the closing capital. The answer will be called adjusted closing capital. What is it? Adjusted closing capital. In adjusted closing capital, you should less opening capital. If you are able to deduct opening capital means the answer will be profit. That means if the answer is positive means it is profit. Suppose it is negative means it is loss. It is the way to calculate the profit and loss through statement of affairs. Now we see one problem. Okay, listen. Sum number 1. Statement of affairs. They are given the particulars. What they are given? Closing capital. Closing capital means year end capital. They are given 3,50,000. They are given drawings 40,000. Drawings 40,000. Just you add it, you got, what is the answer? 3 lakh
90,000.
Then you less additional capital. These items and all they are given in the problem itself. Okay. Then less additional capital 70,000. The answer is 3,20,000. It is called adjusted closing capital. It is called adjusted closing capital. They are given opening capital. How much? 2 lakhs. If you able to deduct means, the answer is here. The answer is profit. What is the answer? 1,20,000.
It is profit.
Are you understand, student? All the items they are given in the problem itself. Closing capital, drawings, additional capital, opening capital. You have to find out profit or loss. You are able to less, you are able to deduct from adjusted capital means the answer will be profit. Otherwise it is loss. Are you understand, students? Now I will give dictate. I will dictate one sum. Just note down the sum. Yes, note on it. Capital at beginning of the year, that is opening capital. Opening capital rupees 5 lakh. Closing capital. Closing capital 8,50,000. Additional capital introduced during the year, that means additional capital 1,20,000. They are given drawing also 70,000. Now you find out the profit or loss. The same method you prepare the statement of offer, you can find out the profit or loss. That's all, students. And thank you very much. We will meet another video. Bye.